that tweeted at me when I said I'm interviewing with Jerry Seinfeld. Said, oh, okay, ask him about their gender diversity on the show.
Yeah, I mean, it's people think it's the census or something. I mean, this has got to represent the actual pie chart of America. Who cares? It's just funny, you know. Funny is the world that I live in. You're funny, I'm interested. You're not funny, I'm not interested. Okay. And I have no interest in gender or race or anything like that. But everyone else is kind of with their little calculating, is this the exact right mix? You know, I think that's, to me, it's anti-comedy. It's okay. Anti-comedy. It's more about, you know, PC nonsense okay. than are you making us laugh or not?
Right, right.
I want to see if you can guess who it is I'm doing an impression of. All right, let me get into character. You got to guess who it is, though. Okay, here it goes. If you do anything wrong in your life, and I find out about it, I'm going to try to take everything away from you. And I don't care what I find out. It could be today, tomorrow, 15, 20 years from now. If I find out, you're fucking finished. Who's that? That's you.
The people that complain and all that type of shit is just, it's a very small group of people and they're bullies. But a comic tells a fucking joke in a strip mall
right.
and all of a sudden they're talking about it.
Right.
You know, one person gets offended. That's another thing too. Like, every one of those things, it's like a comic is guilty of telling a joke in a comedy club. That's all they're guilty of.
Right.
And then what I love too is people get offended by the joke and it's just like, he or she didn't tell you the joke.
Right.
If you want to get mad that you heard the joke,
right.
it's the person that blogs about it. It's the person that takes the video or records it.
Right.
The comedian is just guilty of being in a nightclub
right.
where people voluntarily came in and telling jokes.
Yeah.
And then all of a sudden, just because you're sitting at home eating cornflakes now and you hear the nightclub, that's really on you.
Right.
You don't want to hear the nightclub, don't go to the nightclub, and also don't fucking listen to it. To be honest with you, who really gets offended by comedians? Who is walking around? Like, when was the last time you sold somebody you're a comedian and be like, oh, you guys are so offensive? They always think it's cool,
right.
generally speaking.
Right.
And there's this small group of fucking people. And what I love, too, is they only get offended by shit that has to do with them.
If people can't control their own emotions, then they have to start trying to control other people's behavior. And when you're around super sensitive people, you cannot relax and be spontaneous because you have no idea what's going to upset them next. And that's why I've been warned recently, don't go to most university campuses, because the political correctness has been taken from being a good idea, which is let's not be mean, particularly to people who are not able to look after themselves very well. That's a good idea, to the point where any kind of criticism of any individual or group can be labeled cruel. And the whole point about humor, the whole point about comedy, and believe you me, I've thought about this, is that all comedy is critical. Even if you make a very inclusive joke, like, how'd you make God laugh, answer, tell him your plans. Now, that's about the human condition. It's not excluding anyone. It's saying we all have all these plans which probably won't come, and isn't it funny how we still believe they're going to happen? So that's a very inclusive joke. It's still critical. All humor is critical. And if you start saying, we mustn't criticize or offend them, then humor's gone. With humor goes a sense of proportion. And then as far as I'm concerned, you're living in 1984.
Seriously, though, we've heard a lot about extremism recently, a nastier, harsher atmosphere everywhere, more abuse and bother boy behavior, less friendliness and tolerance and respect for opponents. All right, but what we never hear about extremism is its advantages. Well, the biggest advantage of extremism is that it makes you feel good because it provides you with enemies. Let me explain. The great thing about having enemies is that you can pretend that all the badness in the whole world is in your enemies and all the goodness in the whole world is in you. Attractive, isn't it? So, if you have a lot of anger and resentment in you anyway, and you therefore enjoy abusing people, then you can pretend that you're only doing it because these enemies of yours are such very bad persons. And that if it wasn't for them, you'd actually be good-natured and courteous and rational all the time. So, if you want to feel good, become an extremist. Okay, now you have a choice. If you join the hard left, they'll give you their list of authorized enemies. Almost all kinds of authority, especially the police, the city, Americans, judges, multinational corporations, public schools, furriers, newspaper owners, fox hunters, generals, class traitors, and, of course, moderates. Or, if you'd rather be an extremist on the hard right, no problem, fine, you still get a lovely list of enemies, only they're different ones. Noisy minority groups, unions, Russia, weirdos, demonstrators, welfare sponges, meddlesome clergy, peaceniks, the BBC, strikers, social workers, communists, and, of course, moderates. And upstart actors. Now, once you're armed with one of these super lists of enemies, you can be as nasty as you like and yet feel your behaviors morally justified. So you can strut around abusing people and telling them you could eat them for breakfast and still think of yourself as a champion of the truth, a fighter for the greater good, and not the rather sad paranoid schizoid that you really are.
You're in no position to lecture the public about anything. You know nothing about the real world. Most of you spent less time in school than Greta Thunberg. So, if you win, right, come up, accept your little award, thank your agent and your God, and fuck off.